This is Chris the Idaho Painter here on Paint Life TV. Today I'm going to be reviewing a product. This is a product from Benjamin Moore. This is Regal Select in a flat sheen. I just recently painted a bathroom, a commercial bathroom with this product, and I'm going to give you some of my opinion about this paint, whether it's something that you should buy or use on your upcoming interior product. So if you want to hear what I have to say about Benjamin Moore Regal Select, stay tuned for this video. All right, now I'm going to talk about the product that I use here, premium paint from Regal Select, and this is a flat sheen that I used in this bathroom. It's a premium paint that's 100% acrylic, and it is mildew resistant, so it's great for an interior bathroom. And two of the qualities about this paint that I really liked, that I noticed right off the bat when I'm using this paint, is it covered exceptionally well, and it was very resistant to splattering. And those are two things that will be more annoying in a paint than anything, especially for a do-it-yourselfer, but the coverage was absolutely incredible. This was a dark gray color, and the color that I used, it was called Rockport Gray, and I went to my local Benjamin Moore, selected the color, and here's the Rockport Gray right there. A really cool color for a bathroom, but the coverage, I was going over an existing white, kind of like an antique white, and it almost covered in one coat. Now, I'm typically, as a professional painter, I'm always going to be two coating, but it just about covered in one coat, and I was absolutely amazed that the coverage was extremely great. Very happy with that. The solid content, which is some of the reason why it covered very well, the solid content was 40% by volume, and that's a really high solid paint. And if you don't know anything about the solid content, just to give you some idea, one of the contractor paints that I've used for a lot of years, that's a lot less expensive and is more of a contractor grade, the solid content on that is 29% by volume. And so it just gives you an idea. And the solid content, once the paint's all dried on the wall, that's what's left behind. And the cheaper the paint, the less solids, and the less solids that's left behind after the paint dries. So the solid content is very high. It covered very well. And that solid content also contributes to the ability to for it not to splatter all over the place. And there's nothing more annoying than a paint that just splatters everywhere. And that's what a cheap quality paints with cheap rollers cause a whole lot of splatter. And for do-it-yourselfers, it just makes the whole painting process just not enjoyable. It makes it really messy, and there's a lot of cleanup to do. After painting the entire bathroom, the 9-inch paper that I had around the entire bathroom, where it was covering the toilet, where it was covering the sink, there was absolutely no splatter anywhere. Extremely impressed with that. It's probably the least amount of splatter that I've ever seen with any paint that I've ever used in the interior paint. So very, very impressed with the coverage. Very, very impressed with the ability or lack of splatter from the paint. All right, so another quality that I liked about the product is the low odor. It had very, very low odor. I was working in a very small bathroom, and if you get a paint product that is very strong in odors, for me, I'm very sensitive to those odors. You're just going to get sick. It's not going to be a very pleasant working in a tight space like that. Very low odor, a very pleasant odor, so I was very impressed with that. And when I was rolling the walls, I was rolling out the walls, the paint actually just applied like butter to the walls. It was a very smooth, even flat finish rolling it on the walls. And I was very impressed with how well it worked on the wall. Is when it comes to professional painting, I like to talk about the workability of the paint. So it rolled on very nicely, rolled on very smooth, but it hung very well. And when it comes to hanging, when I'm doing my cut-ins, if you're doing your cut-ins, you're trying to get it to cover in one coat, it's a lot of inexpensive paints and even some high quality paints, you can go back 5 minutes later and you'll have runs with the paint. And so that is the paint's lack of ability to hang very well. And you'll even with some paints, inexpensive paints, roll the wall, get a nice good heavy coat on it, and then it will run. But in this entire bathroom, doing the cut-ins multiple times, rolling the wall, doing one skim coat and then another heavy coat over the top of that. There was not one run, not one sag anywhere with the paint. So I was very impressed with the paint, the paint's ability to hang and hang very well. So there's another quality about the paint that I want to talk about, and it's a paint and primer in one. Now, when it comes to paint and primers in one, you know, some of you may believe in that concept, some of you may not believe in that concept. As a professional painter, I'm never going to take a paint and primer one as its face value and use it as a primer and a paint. If something needs to be primed, I am going to prime it with a specific primer for that reason, and then I'm going to apply, you know, my top coat on top of that. I mean, it being a paint and primer in one, you know, sometimes it'll give you a little bit of security, you know, that I'm priming and painting. But, you know, I'm not, you know, a big fan of, you know, paint and primer in ones, but it is. It claims to be a paint and primer one. So I think that's just one of those things you're going to have to utilize that benefit, you know, to your needs. If you need a paint and primer in one. So, and what that does mean is if you're painting bare sheetrock, so if you're bare sheetrock or drywall, you don't actually have to prime it first. You can use this paint, you know, as your prime coat and then your top coat right after that. Instead of, I would typically with, you know, bare sheetrock or wallboard, use a specific primer like a PVA, a polyvinyl acrylic. I would prime my wall first and then I would top coat it with my paint. And then it's going to actually save you money because a PVA primer is significantly less expensive as a primer versus using your top coat as a primer. All right, another thing I want to talk about when it comes to this paint is the soft, flat finish that it actually left when it was all done. And for a flat paint, it just had this very soft, subtle, flat finish. And it was a dark color, a pretty dark color. Once again, here's the color right here, very dark, and I was going over whites. And you know, with an inexpensive paint, you would have a high likelihood of having what we'd call haloing or lap marks with it. But after the bathroom was completely done, and I even went back and tested it, and I rolled right in the middle of the wall, it had a nice, soft, even finish, and there was absolutely no haloing anywhere. So a difference in color or sheen or from roller marks versus brush marks, you couldn't see any difference where I did all my cut-ins versus the field, the middle, where I did the walls. And even when a few spots where I just tried to touch up right in the middle to test it out, I couldn't even see any place where I went after that. So the tint consistency, the color consistency, the sheen consistency was completely, you know, even across the board, and it absolutely looked amazing. So I was very impressed with that, with the paint. All right, another thing I wanted to talk about when it comes to this product is on the back of the can. It does say it's highly washable, and typically by nature, flat paints aren't highly washable, but when you get into premium paints with very high solids, the washability does go up significantly. So I did test it. I actually everything was dry. I went back the next day and took and scrubbed on it. It took me with a wet rag about 10 scrubs on the wet rag before I started getting the paint on the rag. And so I would say it's not 100% washable like a satin would be or a semi-gloss would be, but for a flat paint, it was, I guess, what they would consider a very washable or scrubbable flat. So I was definitely impressed with the washability of it. Now, some of you may be asking why, I'm sure, when it comes to a flat paint, why are you putting a flat paint in a bathroom? Well, this bathroom is going to look really cool. I'll show you what it's going to look like eventually down the road because I'm doing some metallic suede finishes in the bathroom. So part of it's going to be an undercoat for this metallic suede. And this paint actually acts excellent for an undercoat for the metallic suede finishes I'm going to be using. And one of them is a Boero finish. So it's actually perfect for that. So this bathroom is going to look really cool. And that's why I'm using a flat finish. I want to just take just a minute to talk about the pricing of the Regal Select. I went to a local paint store here that sells the product. Not very many people sell Benjamin Moore paint where I live at. So I went to a small local retail store and purchased the paint. Now, my initial reaction when I purchased the paint was it was a little bit pricey. It was $53.99 a gallon retail price. They didn't tell them I was a contractor. I did call back later on and ask what would be the contractor price for the paint, and it was around $41 a contractor price. So that's a significant savings. I wouldn't have thought it's as pricey if I would have asked for a contractor discount. But I did compare it with two other paints that I feel are very similar to this product, and they're premium paints also. And one of them, the retail price was $71.99 and the other was $63.99. So in the same class that I feel the Regal Select was actually cheaper than those products. The contractor price on one of the products and I use these two products quite often, a lot. One of them was my price, $23.99, and the other one was $41 my price. So the one product would have been equivalent right across the board. So the price was very comparable except for the one paint. Now, if I compare it to a contractor grade paint that we use quite often in new construction and even in a lot in repaints, my contractor price on contractor paint is around $18-$19 a gallon, and that is significantly cheaper, but there is a big trade-off when it comes to contractor paints. My contractor paint gets about 100 to 150 square feet less per gallon. So if you just calculate that into the price, you could start to balance out, you know, that pricey effect. The Regal Select, compared to the two comparable paints that I use and have used a lot over the last 10 years, Regal Select gets 50 square feet per gallon more than those two paints. So even though one of them was quite a bit cheaper, once again, the square feet starts to balance itself out. But a premium paint like this versus a contractor paint, you're going to get way better coverage. And if I was using a paint like a vibrant color or something, I think this would probably cover in two coats. But the contractor paint I'm using would probably take three coats. So now you're getting less square feet per gallon, and you're getting not as good a coverage. So there's more labor and more materials added in. So when you really start to calculate those things out, that whole pricey effect to the paint, it isn't as pricey as you might you think it is, you know, from your initial reaction. But once again, at $53 per gallon retail cost, I think it was worth every penny of that. I mean, I would have ended up paying just $41 if I would have asked for a contractor discount. So that's a little bit on the pricing. Hopefully that makes a whole lot of sense. All right, so what's the verdict? I've gone over quite a bit of stuff when it comes to this paint that I've used and tested. I'll tell you, I would use this paint again, absolutely. I think I'm probably gonna make it one of my go-to paints for doing an interior painting, you know, in the future now. I liked it that much. Three things that I think make this paint worth buying: the coverage of it, the lack of splattering, and then in colors like this, the lack of haloing or lap marks in that soft, smooth finish. Those three things make this paint a great paint, make it worth the money that I paid for it. And I know I could probably, and you can probably get it for cheaper if you just simply walk in and ask, for a contractor discount, or if you're a contractor, just let them know you're a contractor and you'll probably get a little bit cheaper. But once again, that's gonna be all determined on your local paint dealer and where you're actually buying the paint from. I like to, you know, rate paints when it comes to, stars and paints and in products. When it comes to stars, you know, is it a 5-star product or is it a 1-star product? 5-star being the best, 1-star being the worst. This paint, there's just a lot of great things to say about it, but I definitely think it's a great product and worth the money. I probably, if the cost was, you know, a little less expensive, I probably would rate it, a 5-star paint right across the board. But should you purchase the paint, man, it's a great paint. you can't go wrong. You're going to be happy, you know, using this product. It is Benjamin Moore Regal Select, a premium paint, 100% acrylic, washable, and mildew resistant paint. Hopefully you've enjoyed this review. If you have a paint product out there you want me to test out and let you know whether I would use it and whether you should use it, let me know. I'm going to try to do some more paint reviews out there and product reviews to give you some of this valuable information, or my opinion whether it's valuable or not, or whether you should buy it. Leave your suggestions down in the comment section below. If I use your suggestion, we'll give you a $50 gift card to our paint store, Paint Life Supply Co. And you can find the store at paintlifesupply.com. Hope you've enjoyed the video. If you've enjoyed the review, give me a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. That way you get notified next time I come out with a new or next video. Out.